know how it burns. So scared of his return that I can't sleep tonight. In this hospital light, where you call tragedy, it's just another day to me, for my heart beats with fear as his footsteps draw near. The life I'm meant to lead won't slip away from me. 'Cause this time's the last time I'm under my eyes. I've seen too much. This nightmare is not fair. I had enough. You wake me 'cause I bleed. You just say you're sorry. You call this love.
Hello. Thank you for coming to my channel, ladies. Welcome if it's your first time. You're having Girl Talk with Sexy Ruthie. Grab your drink, your wine, your detox water, whatever you prefer. And girlfriend, let's get started. The topic of our story is my divorce story. So make yourself comfortable. Let's hear some juicy stories about what happened. I'm a little hot. I was on stage singing. My other life, I'm gonna be a singer, okay? I love this lady, Celine Dion, and she really helped me a lot during the divorce process. So I don't want to make my videos too long, so this might be a part one and part two after. I was gonna sing the whole song, but my producer said nobody's gonna sit and watch you sing, blah blah blah. 'Cause when I'm on stage, I can go and go and go and sing. Okay, girlfriend, let's get started. For the one that knows me, the people that know that what I went through, I'm just gonna give you a little bit of my story. Hopefully it can help someone out there. I married my high school sweetheart. I won't say no name. We were really young. We fell in love when we were teenagers. And we fell head over heels for each other. And we start dating. It was love at first sight. He liked me, I like him. Then we became boyfriend and girlfriend in high school. And yes, I married my high school sweetheart. 3 years after being in the United States, I went back home to Haiti. We had broke up. So went back, we got back together. He proposed. It wasn't the most romantic one. It wasn't at all. But I agree, and we set a date. And we decided to get married. Mm-hmm. I have spent a lot of money on my wedding because I was the only one working here and he wasn't in Haiti. He had a little studio taking people's pictures, but not as much as I was making over here in the United States. We got married on Christmas, the 25th. What a date, huh? It was an okay wedding. The wedding was, some stuff went bad, but the vows were beautiful. We had a dance, my dress was beautiful, and I will remember this till forever, because he said, tout en respectant les règles de l'amour in French. That's one thing I liked about him. I like a man who speaks French. And that meant he would respect all the rules of love. When the pastor asked him, we had to say our own vows, so he said that. It was beautiful in the beginning. The beginning is always, it's always beautiful. We started our family right away, a year later. God blessed us with our firstborn child, my son. And we start building a family from there. I work really hard while I was in school to bring him to the state to be here with me, because I believe in togetherness. I believe in family. And he came about a year later. He was here in America. And we almost had it all. We almost had the perfect story. We had the kids, the business, building a house in Haiti, about to purchase a house in America, more than one business, we're working. We almost had it all until the breakup. We had broken up before the divorce, twice. So the third time that had happened, I remember exactly. I was laying in the bed with all three kids, taking a nap, and he walked in and he was taking all his stuff out of the closet. And I was calm as water. And that's when I said to myself, how much more can you take of this? He's walking out on you for the third time. I had to evaluate myself. I guess that's where self-love kicked in a little bit. The kids was taking a nap, they did not know. I was just watching him emptying his closet space. And I told myself this time, like the sun said, there is no coming back. I'm doing this for me. What is it that he's looking for that I do not have? I'm done being heartbroken. I'm done of crying. I'm done fixing this. I'm done. And that's when I made the decision to be done with my marriage. I thought we could have the simple little, okay, divorce by you want this, I want that, let's fix this, let's do this. It didn't happen that way. Our poor children was in the middle. Kids are always in the middle. They were little and they didn't deserve what happened to them because they didn't give an explanation. Mommy and daddy love, they didn't get none of that. It just boom, like a car crash. So that day when I saw him moving, like I said, I made a decision to never ever take him back, because I did previously twice. Things happen. I was even friend with one of the mistress, with one of his girlfriend when they broke up. I that's another topic. I was friend with her and not face to face, over the phone. She didn't know that I was the wife, so that's another topic. There was a lot of problems in the marriage. There was infidelity. There was mental abuse as well as physical. It wasn't intense, but it was there. And there was emotional abuse. Arguing all day in front of children is abuse. When a man is telling you you're nothing is abuse. When a man telling you who's man who's gonna have you with all these children is abuse. Nobody's gonna love you. You're done. Nobody's gonna take care of you. Nobody's gonna need you. You have kids. Your life is over. Who's men gonna take you with three kids? So, yes, it does exist. Mental abuse, emotional abuse, physical abuse. Abuse does exist. Did you know when you are married to someone and you refuse to have physical relationship with them, S-E-X, sex, if they force themselves on you, even though you're married, you can press charges? Huh? I didn't know either. It's crazy, because I found that out when I was at the police station trying to get some help, but not knowing that I turned myself in because he had a report that I broke into his house, his new house, which I did. But I didn't break in, someone opened the door and I went in. That's a whole other topic, because there is God. You see, what the enemy meant for bad, God uses it. That's when my faith started building up. I remember being there at the police station and my phone was at 13%. And I had called my cousin to say, I'm here at the police station trying to get papers and trying for them to go help me get my kids' stuff. But they're keeping me. They're asking me all type of questions, not knowing he already called the police, and the police been supposed to be looking for me, but they weren't. I turned myself in. A whole nother story. And there was also financial problem, which is, I think, the number one reason why people get divorced in America. Excuse me one second. Let me remove my gum. A lot of people argue over money when you're in a marriage. If you don't have the same goal, it's a battle that you have to fight each and every single day. Whatever goal it is, financial, physical, if you guys are not on the same page, it's gonna be a battle. Needless to say that it was a very nasty divorce. Divorce is the ripping of two souls. When two people, it's in the Bible, God says, married, they become one. This is why you are not supposed to have sexual relationship outside of a marriage, because your soul become one. You have soul tie with that person. So when our soul ripped apart, we have to mourn the loss. It was hard. I am not gonna sit here and lie. Divorce is hard. It is hard, sis. I do not condemn it. I'm not saying my story to tell someone else to go through it. I'm telling my story because you never know who might need to hear something. It's gonna, if two or three people need to hear this, if it's gonna help them, then I've done my job. I'm just letting you know, sis, that I went through it. And if you're going through it, there is light at the end of the tunnel. There is a God. I didn't know I could go through it. I didn't know. I just thought it was a slap in the, like, okay. But no, it was hard. It was really hard. It was hard on me. It was hard on the kids. And yes, it was hard on him too, because we did love each other. I'm not gonna lie. I'm not gonna sit here and lie. He was the love of my life. I love this man with everything I had in me. Every single thing. And he hurted me the most. I remember, was it this year or last year, that I told him, I will never love another man the way that I loved him. Because I never want a man to hurt me the way he loved me. The problem is, when I fell in love with him, I gave him all of me, thinking that he will give me all of him. Didn't work like that. You give someone all you got. Everything. My money, my everything, my life, my heart, my body. Everything. In a way, I think I made him my God. And this is why God is a jealous God, had to let us go through it, because I gave someone else the number one place in my life. It should be God, not him. But I didn't know. I was just in love, and I said, okay, if I love him, he would love me. If I give him X, Y, and Z, he will give me X, Y, and Z back. No. So when I tell you to love yourself, I know what I'm talking about, sis. When I tell you to create yourself, I know what I'm talking about. You can't give someone what you do not have. I didn't have no love for me. I only had love for him. I thought self-love was, me loving him was, I love him till the end. Yes, I do love you till the end, but did I love me? It was so funny that at the end, when everything was over, I had to learn who I was. Because I didn't know who I was. I was a wife and a mother. That's all I knew at a young age. We were married over a decade. Yes, I look young. Thank you. I got married pretty young. That's all I knew. Being his wife and being the mother to our kids. I didn't know anything else. But there is light at the end of the tunnel. Let me tell you. When a woman is fed up, she's fed up. When I went to what I went to, I had enough. I went to it. And when it comes down to it, divorce is a process. You have to go through the process. During and after. Don't just think you signed the paper, it's over. You have a lot of work to do. Don't just say, okay, now I divorce him, I'm done with him. Not if you have kids with him. I wish it was easier to just tell you, like, okay, you signed a divorce, you happy, I remember that day. Oh sis, I celebrate. I did. And not knowing, I thought it was done. That's the beginning of the end. That was the end of our marriage. But did you know that your soul was tied? You had a lot of work to do. You had a lot of healing to do. I had to process it. Because I hated him. I was angry at him. I had so much resentment inside of me. I blamed him. He blamed me. We had regrets. Oh, we had regrets. Did I have regrets? But when it comes down to it, I had to heal and forgive. That's the next topic of our show. I had to forgive. It's gonna be a part two of the story, so stay tuned. Until then, sis, find yourself, create yourself, heal yourself. Forgive yourself. Most importantly, love yourself. Until next time.